Hello. This is Salva's presentation for the Scarce Discrete Structure 2. It's an online course on the Faculty of Contemporary Sciences and Technology. So, as you know, because this is a this course, Discrete Structure 2, is a continuation of the Discrete Structure 1 course, which is taught during the second semester. So, the students are familiar for this presentation for the way we are going to work, but let me explain once more. Therefore, I'm using this presentation. So as you know, my name is Harry Snopche, and you already know my email address as well as my mobile phone, but there's only one change on the office phone. So as you can see, the office, the last three numbers are 164 instead of 158, which was last year. So for the instructor office hours, you already know. So you have to send me an email to schedule a meeting in Skype. If you want a meeting in Skype, of course, please make an appointment at least 2 days before meeting. We can use Webmail for any kind of communication, and the Webmail may be used according to the requests for additional explanations. You know this. So some of you, you can use also the mobile communication. You can call me at my mobile. Some of you have done it last year, so if you see that it's necessary to communicate by the phone, we can do that. But the basic way of communication is Webmail, and of course we can communicate by Skype if you want directly to explain something additionally. According to the course, Discrete Structure 2, I must say that the course is continues to provide students with mathematical knowledge that has a straightforward application into computer science. A part of the concepts dealt within this module are already known to the students. So, the other part, especially part of numerical analysis, will be new knowledge at all. So, the last 4 weeks, as you will see directly from the syllabus, I plan to discuss about some mathematical properties from numerical analysis, how to use mathematics from numerical analysis to solve equations. The aim here is to formalize this up to a level which allows students to provide ideas for solving different practical problems. What are the course objectives? By the end of this course, you will be able to understand and develop basic concepts of discrete mathematics and relations between them. Then, understand and be able to resolve different problems concerning matrices. When I say problems concerning matrices, I mean operation by matrices, addition and subtraction, as well as matrix multiplication, and multiplication of matrix by scalar. Then, understand and be able to resolve different problems of combinatory. When I say combinatory, I think some combinatorial elements to solve some counting problems. Then we'll discuss about the permutations, combinations, and so on. Then to understand and be able to resolve practical problems by using graph theory. When I say graph theory, we'll discuss about the basic properties of graph theory, operations of graphs, then some applications using chromatic numbers, using Euler paths, and so on. Then to understand, be able to apply the division algorithm. So we'll discuss about the division algorithm and where it can be applied. To understand, be able to apply the Euclid's algorithm. Then to understand and be able to resolve different problems concerning the Boolean algebra. So we'll define what is the Boolean algebra and how can we use it. And then to understand and be able to use the features of the computer arithmetics. And finally, to understand and be able to resolve different problems using the basic concepts of numerical analysis. When I say numerical analysis, especially to solve the equations, using the bisection method, using the fixed point method, and using the Newton-Raphson method. Both expectations are the same as the last year. The guidelines are the same, let me repeat only. So the students are required to use Libby and regularly to send the homework at the end of each week. You know, I'm sending the materials in Libby and putting the materials in Libby at the end of each week, either Friday or sometimes Saturday, as you know. I will continue by the same process this week as well. Then, you know about the incomplete grade, you know about the feedback, so you have to send me the solved homework after the end of the next week. So you have, you know, you have at least 8 days to solve the homeworks and to send me the homework back. And about the plagiarism, you know that you are not the plagiarism is not tolerated, and you already know that what is the plagiarism. So I don't want to repeat this thing. And finally, about the grading policy. The grading policy is the same as last week, as the course discrete structures one. So you know you have 2 midterm exams. You have to solve homework. All of them have by 30% of points. And adding to these points from the activity and discussion, which is connected by your interest about the subjects, you can receive in total 100 points. So, you know, after the second midterm exam, I will give the proposal grade. If you are satisfied by the proposal grade, then everything is okay. You'll have that grade. Otherwise, if you are not satisfied by the proposal grade, or if for any other reason you have not participated at the, let's say, midterm exams, then you will come to the final exam. The final exam has in total 60%, and together by homework and activity, the total number of points is again 100%. And on the right side of this slide, you can see the grading scale. It's the same also as the scale of last year. So, you know, if you have less than 50% of points, you will receive the grade 5. If the number of points is between 51 and 64, your grade will be 6, and so on. The grade 10 is if you have in total more than 95% of points. So this is all about the syllabus of distance structure 2. You are familiar how is the work on these subjects. I said it's a continuation of the subject distance structure 1, and don't hesitate to contact me and to ask me everything concerning this subject. Thank you very much.